I'll have voice chat up in a second. I'm going to start it from scratch. I don't have it up right now, but we're going to make a new Debian right now, and we're going to get it up and running. Okay, so here we're going to do new, and we're going to type in the name, which is going to be Jitsi Free My IP, Jitsi Meet, Headless. Actually, it's the third today, isn't it? I was going to do it yesterday, so let's change this date to the third. I was pretty fucking tired yesterday, so we're going to choose the ISO, which is going to be Debian Linux. It's going to be right here, Debian Linux Bullseye 11.7.0 from last month, or a little over a month ago. All right, we're gonna do 8 gigs of memory, 4 CPUs. We're gonna set about 25 gigs or so. All right, let's see. Bidirectional. Add some memory here. We'll set the bridge adapter to, you know what, we're probably going to have MAC address. Yep. We're going to have to put the MAC address in there. There we go. Set this MAC address up. Is it streaming? Okay, okay, good. Pretty high bit rate here, so I'm going to set this MAC address so we can have the ports all set up already. Uncheck that. We're going to uncheck that. Then we're going to hit OK. Then we're going to... Boom! Boom goes the dynamite. And we're going to follow this fucking guide is what we're going to do, because I just wrote this yesterday. I cleaned it up. I'm going to see if I can follow it all the way through. We're going to do an install here. It's actually the second option down. Okay. English, United States, English. We're going to do host name as default. No root password. We're going to do a username, though, and a password. Central. Guided, use entire disk. All files on one partition. Finished, right. Where is he? Let's go, punk. Let's go, punk. I have to reinstall this because mine wasn't really set up properly. And I think people have an easier time connecting to my jitsi.freemyip.com instead of caterwaul.chickenkiller.com. There's something to do with the name Chicken Killer that alerts every fucking browser for some reason, dude. I haven't pinpointed it yet, but for some reason, the name Killer or something. Like, who cares if it's, you know, strangleallgrandmothers.org? Who cares what the hell the name is, man? It's a fucking website. You let people go to it. You don't try to stop people from going to a website because of its name. I haven't confirmed it, but that's what it feels like so far. All right, we're only going to allow SSH. We're not going to do the desktop environment, GNOME, or anything like that. We're just going to do the bottom two. Because we need SSH to log in via PuTTY. Yep, we'll do grub. Select that. Okay, installation complete. All right, here we go. Once in Linux, log into the username you created. All right, there we go. Now, sudo password. Okay, now we're gonna log into root. There we go, we're in root. Now we're gonna nano slash etc slash ssh sshd config permit root login, which is right here. We're gonna remove the hashtag or pound sign and then change this to yes. Control O. So now that we got that, we gotta do slash etc slash init dot d ssh restart. And now we should be able to log in with PuTTY. Okay, right into root. And we're in, all right, good. So we can minimize this screen, we don't need this one anymore. And we're gonna do a couple other things here. We're gonna do this grub deal. We're gonna change it from grub default 1, timeout 0. Then we're gonna update grub. Then we're gonna double check the sources list. I guess contrib non-free. Contrib non-free. That's good. Then we're gonna app update. It's wget, make sure we got it, okay. We're gonna grab this, then we're gonna change this host. Oh, I forgot the second part of it, damn it. Hold on, I forgot the second part. There it is, bash Jitsi Jabri installer, okay. That's the one I forgot. Good thing I'm checking this over here. Type yes, and it should fucking fly through and do all the installation for me. And I'll have the latest version of Jitsi as well. So here it goes. This is from a fresh install of Linux, and we're doing all this shit in the background. Long live Linux. Uh-oh. Oh, my port's not right, huh? Okay, hold on 1 second. God damn it. Oh, okay. I changed the port 80. Aw, oh, fuck. Alright, take two. Hold on, we're applying here. And let's pop this. All right, let's do it again. Sorry about that. Yeah, make sure all your ports are open or this fucking script doesn't work. I had port 80 pointing to my Windows machine because I was doing a test for a friend of mine on Discord, showing him how easy it is to set up a web server. He had no idea, dude. I showed him how easy it was. There we go. Now it's checking the ports. Yep, and it's going. I know it looks weird, doesn't it? Like all this text? What the fuck is that shit? Well, this is kind of how the internet works, you know? It's just text. And then when we go to these websites, they got pictures and they have clickable shit and they got video. It's all because of these packages and these, you know, these software packages in the background. These servers, these web servers running in the background on many, many, many machines across the planet. We're also going to talk a little bit about encryption today. Came across some very interesting videos that are not on YouTube, but they're there on YouTube, but they're unlisted. I had to find them a secret way. The videos have almost no views, but they're pretty compelling videos. One of them is from a woman who talks a lot about cryptology or cryptograph or whatever. And she talks about the government, Edward Snowden, stuff like that. And she actually knows what she's talking about, it seems like. So I'm very interested to see that video. And after I get this up and running, I'm probably going to load that sucking fucking video up. So I guess as that's going, I can go over some previews of some of the videos that I downloaded today. Let's look at what kids think of the internet. How about that? Here we go. Here's what kids think of the internet.
My name is Emma Stickle, and if you're looking for me on the internet, you'll find me at 0, which is not my IQ number. Well, the reason that the internet has attracted many younger people is because adults tend to like, you know, TV better, because the internet involves, you know, everything. You know, it involves, you know, using your mind, which younger people tend to enjoy more than older people.
Yeah. I would say that internet has changed my life. I just say it's something to do when I'm bored.
I'd rather do internet because I get to actually be with my friends on internet. And if I'm going fishing, I can only be with a couple of my friends, but on internet, I can be with all of them at once.
Well, one thing I like to improve about the internet is the cost of everything. Because if you're just a kid and you know, your friends are all into the internet and you'd like to go explore to see what it is, and you ask your parents, you know, can we get a computer with a modem and a phone line hookup to get on the internet? And they say, oh, well, how much does it cost? And you say, oh, a computer costs about $1,500 and a modem costs $60. And they say, oh, no, that's way out of the price range.
There's a girl I know, and she has a boyfriend on internet, and I don't know if he's still her boyfriend, but as far as I know, he could be completely ugly, and yet he's still her boyfriend because they talk to each other on the internet. And they create posters on the internet about, like, Sphere loves Dynamite and Dynamite loves Sphere.
I just like talking to people. You know, people on, because, you know, people that think higher than me, and they give me some information, like, about school. When I was in school, I was having some trouble with, you know, the work and stuff. So I was talking to one person, and he gave me some information on what I should do, you know. And he said that, you know, you are ahead of a lot of people because of your age and what grade you're in, and you should be proud of that.
Our parents, they're used to using telephones and watching TV instead of using the telephone and TV sort of mixed together. My mom was the one who got the computer, but I'm the one who uses it mostly. She does business stuff on it, but she doesn't use the modem a lot. I was showing it to my parents last night, and they weren't really interested, but of course, this was like 10 o'clock at night.
The reason I think the net is really cool is because, you know, you get to create your worlds of your own. You get to build up social skills, physical skills. Your fingers get really tired, I have to tell you, but it's worth it. The internet, you know, I laugh a lot. It's really funny because a lot of the stuff people say is funny. So if someone was watching me, they'd see me giggle.
I think the internet is going to go very commercialized soon because you can already see it happening and stuff. Like, you can see a web server somewhere where you can order a pizza or something. There's a Pizza Hut web server somewhere. You enter your home phone number and your name, and then... So I think eventually the internet is just gonna become a big commercialized thing.
Yeah, that's what it did.
And they're just gonna have to make a new network for public use.
Did you hear that? Like way back then in the 90s, the guy knew it was coming commercial. So he wanted to make a second internet for just regular people, man. We almost need that because everything is fucking commercial.
For the guys who are the ARPANET pioneers, I'd have to say that they're pretty geniuses, because 25 years ago, no one would have ever thought of anything like this. Most people didn't even own a computer. So people would never have thought of computers through the phone lines. And I think to just even imagine that, not even to create it, but even to imagine it, you have to be a genius.
Oh man, that's back in the day. Hey, look at that, my server's up. All right, let me see, let me get that fucking roll in here. Jitsi, all right. Yep, it's running. Okay. I don't have the whiteboard yet, so I want to get that rolling. Let's work on it. Here we go. So we got installed Node.js. I'm going to do that here. Actually, I'm going to exit this one. Okay. Don't need that sudo. Okay. We got to create a user. Password. Okay, all right, npm install, let's do it. Okay, let's get this version. Don't forget to write sudo in the front. Okay, we're gonna have to do this production port deal. Okay, 9091. Port 9091. Oops, I forgot the colon. Okay, then we're gonna do this npm start. All right, good. Now we're gonna have to open up a second one. Okay, I'm gonna have to modify some stuff here. AV moderation under room metadata. Wait a minute. Under room metadata. Okay. That would be right here. WebSocket. Okay, we're on the next one. Alright, first thing we gotta do is comment out the WebSocket right here. Guess we can keep that one commented. There's the whiteboard. Oh, shit. Shit. I gotta close this and reopen it. I gotta do that again real quick. Collab. Okay. Alright, there we go. Now, let's see. Okay, that's commented out. Alright, that's it for that. Now we have to go over here and add this. Underneath XMPP WebSockets. Right here. Okay. Okay, done. Sudo reboot. Okay. Come on. Come on. Try it again. There it is. Oops. Let me try one more time. I want to log in as Excali. We're going to do this debug npm start. Okay. Alt space D. Okay. Okay. Actually, I probably didn't need to do this other one here. Sudo reboot. Okay, now it should work. The whiteboard should work, that is. There we go. Whiteboard, here it is. Hi. There it is. Okay, muted. Alright, so this one should work. Yep. Okay. There's a couple other changes here. Actually, I didn't even need to do this one. Don't need to debug at all. Okay, we're gonna do this. The C drive, program files, Oracle. VirtuBox, CMD, headless. Oh, I guess, do I have to shut down? Okay, probably gotta shut down. There we go. So now when I double click it, we're going to do this. Thank you. Ah, fuck. Okay, disabled notifications. I'm just going to go like this. This will be easier. There we go. End conference. Okay. Deep linking. True. Okay, that's good. Try that. Should be good to go, man. Boop. Cool. Working. Let me double check by getting on my phone in 5G. Hello. 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 Working? All right, I'm logged on my cell phone now, so you can obviously hear it. Let me open up the whiteboard and just double check the whiteboard. I'm gonna start drawing on my cell phone, okay? Oh, look at that. NES blow. Phones blow. They're kind of wrote it a little bit. Phones blow. All right.
End-to-end encryption is on. End-to-end encryption is off.
Yeah, isn't it awesome, dude? Voice chats just from nothing, from scratch. I got a voice server up and running. I got a whiteboard working. It has encryption. It just, you know, Jitsi has screen sharing. It just has everything, man. It's pretty fantastic. Right down here, there's screen share. There's, you know, you can turn your camera on and off anytime. You can mute it anytime. Screen sharing. You can have a text chat. Text is not yet encrypted, but perhaps in the future, it will be, like voice and video is. So then you got little hand gestures, you can clap or whatever. It'll do a little animation like that. It'll show everybody in the room. You can raise your hand like, hey, can I talk? Type of thing. You can actually stream from this to YouTube. If you hit start live stream, it'll ask you for your stream key. And it's totally legitimate too. Works directly from this. And it seems to work pretty well. I've done it before. You can share video, so if you paste a video link, everybody in the chat can see it and hear it. You can put noise suppression on if you want. You can have start recording, and you can actually record on your device or the server's device. That's why it says your recording will be saved by the recording service, meaning it will link you. Let me see if I can hit it. I'm going to just hit start recording. And
recording is on.
Okay, I think it's recording. So now we want to stop recording.
Recording has stopped.
And you saw that in the text there. They gave you a link to access the recorded video after recording is complete. And there's a link to my server again, or a little page. And there's the MP4 file. You can just download it. You could just download the recording and record it on my server for you. So you don't have to use any kind of recording device on your system, whether it's a cell phone or a tablet or whatever. You could record using my server and get the video. It's pretty awesome. But yeah, I can also disable it so it doesn't alert other people that there's recording. I can do silent recording, or because on default it's set to public, so it'll tell everybody it's recording. But yeah, some of the cool things at Jitsi there, Jitsi Meet. Free, open source, you can do whatever you want with it. And as I said, I'm running it right here in a virtual box. I'm going to move this up, if I can, to here. Well, I guess I can't move it right now, but should be able to move it sometime. Okay, maybe I got to shut it down to move it, but whatever.